What results can a Power BI beginner get in just 30 days? You're going to meet one of our 30-day dashboard challenge participants and see that you can quickly get incredible results with Power BI, even if you feel like a beginner right now. When Kyle started on his journey, he had perhaps the same doubts and fear that you have. But listen to him share his journey and see what he was able to accomplish. And you can get the same results by participating in a 30-day dashboard challenge. Just visit learnpowerbi.com/challenge to learn more and sign up.
Hi, everyone. You can see my screen, right, Abby?
Yep, we can, yeah.
All right, so my name's Kyle. I'm an employee benefits consultant. So what I do is I help employers design their employee benefits packages. So this would be to attract new talent as well as to retain the employees they have, and ultimately to take care of them as well, including the health conditions that their employees might have. So in Canada, we have a public medical system, but it doesn't cover everything. So for example, drugs aren't covered under the health system in Canada, as well as what we call paramedical claims. So things like physiotherapy, massage therapy, psychologists even. Travel coverage. If somebody wants to go out of country, then the Canadian government's not necessarily going to pay for when they need to go to a hospital on that vacation to the Bahamas, for example. And then there's some other medical services and supplies. Hospitalization, if somebody wants to go in a non-wardroom, isn't covered by the province. So basically, an employer can take anything that's not covered by the government and decide what they want to provide for their employees. So this is a good way to attract employees. And these plans will generally not just include the employee, but also their whole family. So you'll have an employee, their spouse, as well as their children will all be covered by these programs. So I worked in this industry for about 10 years and then left my job in January to start my own company. And one area that I think will be a big differentiator for my company is the data analytics behind these programs. So a cool thing about this industry is in insurance, there's always a lot of data. So a lot of data to crunch through. Historically, I became better and better with Excel. But of course, you can hit the limitations of Excel pretty quickly if you're using too many rows of data. So within my old company, similar to Poorney, I kind of worked my way up to a level where I wasn't able to really dig into the data anymore. So my job was to peer review what other people were doing, make sure everything made sense, but I wasn't really allowed to build my own models and that type of thing. So one of the things I'm excited about my new company is going back to really being able to dig in and do some of this analytics work. So this dashboard specifically is to help an employer figure out what types of health conditions their employees might be facing, as well as their employees' families, in order to design their wellness programs. So some employers will design wellness programs, such as providing gym memberships or maybe some special mental health support, that type of thing. So it's good for an employer to be able to track how the health of their employees at their organization are evolving. So what I've got here is I've split the claims that come through from the insurer into healthcare and drugs. So drugs are generally the largest portion of these programs. And then I've basically mapped, so these are two data sets. One was the healthcare claims, one was drugs. And I've mapped these all onto different health conditions. So I've got 200,000 claims here. With different codes that I've then mapped into what the health condition is that drug addresses, for example, or that type of service or medical supply would apply to. And then within the program, there's some different groups that are covered. So there's retirees, there's salaried employees, as well as unionized employees. There's actually like 12 different groups, but they can all be kind of mapped into these three different categories. So I've mapped those into a slicer. And then I figured an employer also might be interested in, okay, of the claims that are coming through, what which claims actually relate to my employee and what are the health conditions that my employees are facing versus their spouses and their children. So I've got one quick visual here where basically you can click on it to filter down. So if you wanted to look at the health conditions just for the employees, for example, you would see musculoskeletal is the first, autoimmune diseases, and then mental health would be number three. Whereas if you're just looking at the total group, you see musculoskeletal first and then mental health. So yeah, it's kind of cool that they can drill down. I haven't actually shown this to any clients or prospects yet, but the idea was that I was polishing it as I went. So Abby gave me some pretty good feedback to start with, which I've incorporated so far. Yeah. So I show the evolution over time as well. I've got 5 years of data. I actually should say this one's only 3/4 of a year. So one thing that I'm going to be looking to learn in the future is how to annualize when I've got years that aren't complete yet, and ideally have that as a variable. So as I collect data, say every quarter, I could just maybe have a parameter that then annualizes that as I go. So I'll be looking to learn that. And yeah, Abby also pointed out some color issues where I had elements that were in the same color, but they were actually different elements. So I've fixed that a little bit as well. One thing that was really awesome that I learned in this is with tooltips, you can either define your tooltips right within a given dashboard, or you can create a new page and have that be your tooltip. So I found this was awesome for if I'm looking at my drugs, for example, I could look and say, oh, okay, mental health is something that I know my client is interested in. What are those different mental health conditions? So I can go into my tooltip and then it blows up into a tree map. So it's like, okay, depression is clearly the first one. Then they've got some multiple sclerosis claims going through. And basically it gives them a better picture of how that distribution within mental health is broken down. So this is really helpful for them then to define what kind of programs they should have. Like, should they then get a third party to help them with their mental health disorders? If it's on the drugs, for example, are they covering all of the right drugs to be able to help people with depression, for example? So yeah, I can also do that within this graph, within the paramedical claims, for example. I can see, okay, physiotherapy is my biggest driver, followed by chiropractor services, psychologists, massage therapy, etc. What's really cool too is I can just click on a given condition to then have all of these drill down. And then I can say, okay, so just for mental health, what were the paramedical claims? Okay, psychologists and social workers. And by far the most is the psychologist claims. So yeah, I see this being a pretty cool functionality for employers to kind of not only get a picture of what the health conditions are that their employees face now, but to kind of track it as they evolve. So if they put in new mental health supports, for example, they could continue to track, okay, is this actually causing a reduction in drug claims, for example? And yeah, just kind of keep tabs on the health of their organization.
Man, this is incredible. And I will say that, I don't use tooltips as often, but they look lovely. And it can be a nice surprise, right? I mean, sometimes when somebody's like, I'm imagining like a new user and they're hovering around and go, oh, whoa, you know? And once it does pop up, it's pretty intuitive. So love that. Love seeing that. Okay, do you mind just doing it again? Just hover over something. I want to see the tooltip again. Oh, God, that is so cool. Oh, you know, so we should have all had jetpacks by now, right? I mean, you go back and read the science fiction novels or whatever, you want the Jetsons. Yeah, we should be, you know, but we don't have jetpacks, but we have this. And I think this is a better deal. So Kyle, hey, this is super incredible. And this is reminding me of another person who was in a different industry, but kind of doing the same work that you're doing, Matt Bracken. And he was in the energy industry and he would go to companies to help them save the energy costs. But before Power BI, it was a long conversation. You know, it was like, yeah, this is what we do, blah, blah, right? It was just really drawn out conversation, which of course meant that he had to put in a lot of effort to gain new customers. But then he switched to something like UN Belt, and he said, oh, here's how the energy thing works, and here are the peaks and valleys of the energy. And if you would have bought in October, if you had been working with me, then you would have saved this much money, right? And again, just putting that visual made it so much easier. So I'm imagining, so of course, I think the timing is brilliant. Timing is spot on, because of course, the everybody knows the great resignation, great revolt, all of that stuff going on. And I think it's about time, because I think the world needs employers who really, truly care about their employees, right? Not like, oh yeah, you know, we're going to give them free food so they can work longer, you know, free laundry so that they don't go home. None of that mentality, right? I mean, do something, but do it with the right reason. So the world needs employers who really care. And that's what I see this doing, right? It's like, hey, how can we really take care for employees? I run a business too. So I know resources are sometimes limited. Right? So of course, if we get unlimited resources, we're like, yeah, let's take care of everybody. Well, we can't. But the idea is, how can we maximize the resources? And I see that's what your report does. Like, a well-intentioned employer wants to take care of their employees, and this can show them how. Like, hey, look, this is what your employees need. And I love it, right? And of course, you know, like in business, like one size doesn't fit all. So it's like, yeah, one company A's employees might be totally different. And you know, I would bet that even companies who you would think would be similar, who are maybe located in the same space, you would see very different things when you look at the data, or who are in the same kind of industry. Like, so let's say mining or oil and gas, but you go from company A to company B, and it could be very different. And this is what you can bring to them. So, hey, man, I'm super excited for this. So I'll ask you the same question. Now that you have this, what does it make possible for you in the new year? Where can you go? Or maybe otherwise you wouldn't have, or it would have taken longer, it would have been harder. Yeah.
Yeah. So for one, I liked your concept, Abby, of just trying, failing, and then continuing to learn as you go. So this is my first crack at this, but I think I'll get some good ideas from my clients. So I'll be showing them this, and then they'll be able to tell me, oh, this is cool, but I'd also like to see this or that. So I'll continue to kind of customize it. And then, yeah, as I'll use it for marketing purposes, but then also look with prospects and be able to look at this in a live setting, as you were saying that Matt did. And then I could ask them, what would you like to see in this? And I know my competitors aren't sitting down with them and doing that. So yeah, a little more background. The insurance companies, they have their own reports, but they're these standardized reports. So they'll basically, a consultant will take that insurer report, slap their own logo on it and say, hey, here you go, client. But the client can't play with that. Whereas I feel like, yeah, this will really allow me to empower my clients to really play with their data.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I've heard, I'm thinking of another gentleman, can't remember his name, but he works out of France. And he was saying that doing something like this, it has helped him retain existing customers, right? Because they love having visibility, more visibility into how he's serving them, what's going on. Helps retain customers, helps gain new customers, helps grow business with existing customers. Because once they can see, then it gives you a discussion point. Then you can explain, hey, what about this? Can we do this? Can we do that? Right? So it helps him grow business with an existing customer. And there was this last point, which is a bit deeper, but he was saying he was developing new product lines, right? Product lines and services. So yeah, great, great, great. Hey, thank you so much. And this is so inspiring.